Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Nahmadu wa nusalli ala rasulil kareem ma ba'd. Short bayan. Today we talk about Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu zikrullaha zikran kaseera. Believers do zikr kaseer. Abundance of zikr. Lots and lots and lots and lots of zikr. Quran and Hadith put great stress on abundance of zikrullah. Remember Allah, remember Allah, remember Allah. In Surah Al-Ahzab, Allah said in one place, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرَ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. And in the same surah, after a few pages, Allah said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ وَنُذْكُرُ اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا وَسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا هُوَ الَّذِي يُصَلِّي عَلَيْكُمْ وَمَلَائِكَتُهُ لِيُخْرِجَكُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا. In Surah Al-Jumu'ah, Allah said, وَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. In Surah Maryam, Allah said to Zakariya alayhi salam, وَذْكُرْ رَبَّكَ كَثِيرًا وَسَبِّحْ بِالْعَشِيِّ وَالْإِبْكَارِ. Sorry, this is the Surah Al-Imran, 35. وَذْكُرْ رَبَّكَ كَثِيرًا وَسَبِّحْ بِالْعَشِيِّ وَالْإِبْكَارِ. So we see the word Zikran Kaseera in many places. Allah instructed the prophets to do Zikr Kaseer of Allah. Allah instructed us as Ummat-e-Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to do zikre kaseer. In fact, Allah mentioned in the first verse of 21st Sipara, اُتْلُ مَا أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةِ إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ وَلَذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرِ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ مَا تَصْنَعُونَ. What is the meaning of وَلَا ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ? Allah's zikr is the greatest. It's the greatest blessing and ni'mat a person can have. The greatest ni'mat you can have is Allah's zikr. And in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah said, فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرُكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. Remember me and I will remember you. And be grateful to me, don't be ungrateful. In Surah Al-Ra'd, Allah said, أَلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. Those who have iman, their hearts feel at ease with peace and tranquility upon the zikr of Allah. Lo, listen carefully, it is with the zikr of Allah do hearts find peace and tranquility and sukoon. If you want itminane qalb, it is in zikrullah. And you go on zikrullah, many, many ayat, read Fazail-e Zikr of Hazrat Shaykh Naqbulullah Umar Qadhu, nearly 70 verses with regard to zikrullah. We can understand how important Allah's zikr is. What can we say? Today, Shaitan is very cunning. He's worked on us. And he has made people's mentality think that if you do too much zikr, you become mad. Don't do too much zikr, otherwise you lose your brain. You become insane, you become pagal. If you do too much zikr, you become pagal. Ya Allah. Allah on one side is telling us, do as much zikr as you can. And over here, Shaitan has brainwashed us into thinking that if you do too much zikr, you become pagal. Our mentality is such that if we see someone doing lots of zikr and maybe sometimes crying in zikr, Shaitan whispers in us that he's got some problem, take him to a psychiatrist. He needs to see
some psychiatrists, because it's crime. So if someone cries out of fear of Allah, we'll feel that there's something wrong with him. This is how the society has been twisted. And this has effect on us. We are going through COVID-19. We should be turning to Allah and seeking Allah's help for the removal of the disease and the virus. But here we are, in many places our masajid are closed. South London, whole London, nearly whole London closed. No Jummah, no Jamaat. One friend who is a zimmedar of a masjid texted me last night, "We are thinking of closing our masjid because there is too much this and that." I said to him, "Why are you so scared?" I said, "No, I'm not scared." "But you sound scared." Now, then I thought, you know, that there are two things here. One thing which is definite, and another thing which is indefinite, probable, possible. Why do you leave something that is definite for something that is possible? Coming to the masjid, benefiting from the masjid, benefiting from the du'as, from the zikr, from the jama'at, from the namaz, Allah's rahmat, Allah's mercy. This is definite, yaqeeni, mutahakkak. When you come to masjid, you do ibadat, you worship Allah, you definitely get Allah's rahmat and Allah's mercy and maghfirat. And Allah has everything in control. You know, no one can get any disease without the hukum of Allah. This is definite, this is our iman yaqeen. Do we not believe in taqdeer? What is taqdeer? Believing in everything good or bad is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we come to masjid, we come to strengthen our iman. And the iman and yaqeen becoming strong is definite. So on one thing, on one side we have something that is definite, it's bound to happen, we will gain it. On the other side there is something which we fear, which is mawhoom, which is not yaqeeni. There are masajid open in UP and around the world and nothing is happening to anyone. Have you ever heard COVID spreading from masjid? It might have spread from pubs, it might have spread from someone going to Spain and coming and having a party. But you never heard that some masjid spread COVID. So the spreading from masjid is only a wahmi possibility, let's say probability, possible. Imkan. So something which is definite, why are you closing the masjid and leaving that which is definite because of something which is possible? Mawhoom. I don't understand. So we have to turn to Allah, remember Allah, bring Allah in our hearts and minds, and with Allah's zikr, all the dark patch on our hearts will be removed. The mist which covers our hearts. Like, you know, when you have a shower, then the mirror in your bathroom will have steam over it, you can't see your face in it. Similarly, when we are in negligence, when we forget Allah, when we sin, when we disobey, this type of mist forms on the heart. That is Arabic, in Arabic is called rain. It's mentioned in Surah Al-Mutaffifin. Kalla, bal rana ala qulubihim ma kanu yaksibun. Whatever they had been doing has formed a mist, a dark patch on their heart. We need to remove that, we need to clean it, polish it. And how can we polish our hearts? How can we polish the heart? How can we remove it? Allah's Rasul will tell us. لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ سِقَالَةٌ وَسِقَالَةُ الْقُلُوبِ ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ. Everything has to polish. And the polish of the heart is zikrullah. Polish of the heart is zikrullah. So we need to increase our level of zikr. When we have too many fitnas surrounding us, what we need to do is don't pay attention to those fitnas. Come to Allah. Increase our ibadah. Come to masjid. Come to majlis of zikr. You know, come to namaz. Stay in masjid. From one namaz to another namaz. Read Quran Sharif. Spend time in masjid. And you know, at home, when you have free time, sit down. Don't watch movies. Don't watch films. Don't play games. You know, don't fall into ghaflat and negligence.
Do something constructive. Utilize your time. Value your life. And then inshallah, all these dark patches on the hearts will be clean. Our hearts will be purified. We will draw ourselves closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what needs to be done. This is why Allah said, Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu dhkuru allaha dhikran kaseera. Do lots and lots and lots of dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not little, not less, lots of dhikr. Don't fall into ghaflat. وَلَا تَكُمْ مِنَ الْغَافِلِينَ Allah said towards the end of Surah Al-A'raf, وَاذْكُرْ رَبَّكَ فِي نَفْسِكَ تَضَرُّعًا وَخِيفَةً وَدُونَ الْجَهْرِ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ بِالْغُدُوِّ وَالْآصَالِ وَلَا تَكُمْ مِنَ الْغَافِلِينَ Do zikr with a little bit of voice while pleading to Allah, crying to Allah. When you plead to someone, you cry to Allah, plead to Allah, remember Allah. تَضَرُّعًا وَخِيفَةً with fear of Allah. And morning and evening, بِالْغُدُوِّ وَالْآصَالِ And وَلَا تَكُمْ مِنُ الْغَافِلِينَ Do not be negligent. Today we are negligent. We are falling into ghaflat. Too much ghaflat around everywhere. Too much ghaflat. This ghaflat is getting the better of shaitan. Shaitan jumps with joy when we are ghaflat. Shaitan sits on our hearts with his trunk. And when we are ghaflat, he keeps poking, whispering. As soon as we do zikr of Allah, he runs away. This is the meaning of al-waswasul khannas. He does waswasa, and as soon as we do zikr, he retreats and runs away. So, shaitan is getting the better of us by putting us into ghaflat. What we need to do is turn away from ghaflat and turn towards zikrullah. The more zikr we do, the better for us. This reminded me of the story which Sheikh Hazrat Maulana Rashid Ahmad Gangohi mentioned. I'll do it very quickly, summary. Hazrat Rai, there was a person who was asked, Who is your peer? Who is your sheikh? He said, I have my sheikh, but I have two other sheikhs as well, two other peers. One peer is a soldier, and another peer is a parrot. Then how can a soldier and a parrot be a peer? He said, well, there was a soldier in our neighborhood, and I used to see him every day, bang on 6 a.m., he's up, and he's doing his, you know, ghusl, washing himself, and putting his uniform on, and wardi and everything ready, parading towards his work. And in the evening, 5 o'clock, bang on time, he's back. And in the evening, whatever he needs to do, he's doing. Every day, same routine and system. So I thought to myself that this person is working so hard for his daily bread. How much should I work for my akhirah? He's working for dunya, so much, so punctual. His life is so systematic, so organized. And my life is unorganized. No system in my life. I need to bring some system in my life, discipline myself. So I made a sheet and I wrote everything I have to do for my akhirah, my fajr, my zohar, my asr, my maghrib, my isha, my Quran Sharif, my Durood Sharif, my tilawat, my zikr, and everything. And I train myself to bring my life in order. I learn this discipline from that soldier, so he is my peer. And the parrot is my peer because one of my friends had a parrot whom they taught to say, Miyamittu, Miyamittu, Miyamittu. So whenever someone comes, he would say, Miyamittu. So one day I was at his home, they opened the cage and he was flying around and he sat in one corner, there was a rope hanging. So somehow the rope made a noose around his neck. And as he tried to fly away, the noose tightened and he got strung up. And he was trying to fly away, people are running frantically looking for a chair to save him. But nobody could save him and he died while saying, So I looked at all that and I said, oh, I took a lesson from there. A person at the time of death will say whatever he has been saying through his life. So I started saying La ilaha illallah, I started saying Allah Allah, so that at the time of death Allah's name comes on my lips. Otherwise, whatever you are busy in will come out at the time. If you will songs, then songs will come out when you're dying. If you're into movies, movies will come out when you're dying. If you're into sports, sports will come out. Films will come out. So, if you are money making, you will count money when you're dying. Whatever you are busy in throughout your daily life, that's what will come out at the life. You know, at death, you know, reality kicks in. You can't pretend to be what you're not. It's real reality because you're in so much pain, the reality comes out. You can't pretend. So, at the time of death, I want zikr to come out of my lips. This is why I started doing zikr of Allah. And the parrot taught me zikrullah. So, the parrot is my second peer. The soldier is my own peer because he disciplined me. The parrot is my peer because I learned zikrullah from him. May Allah give us tawfiq to bring some discipline in our lives and to do zikr of Allah in abundance. In all these verses which I recited, the word is zikran kaseera, zikran kaseera, zikran kaseera. We are into zikr qaleel, falling into ghaflat, negligence. May Allah protect us. May Allah pray us. Wa akhir da'wana.